my linguiners. Let's see what we got here. Come on, let's go. APU needs to kick in now. There she goes, back to normal operation. She blows even better than before, guys. Now come on now. Evaporator fans shut off all the way, it kills the engine. It kills the engine. So anyway, here we go. Had to take the bracket off and take the skirt off. Started by taking the steps off here. The steps came off with 8 Torx bit bolts. And then on the top plate, which is inside the truck. Anyway, AC compressor is running. It shows that it had service January 6th. And she runs just fine. The oil level's good. I'm gonna order all the service kit, the oil and the filters, and I'm gonna do that here soon anyway. But you get an air filter, a fuel filter, an oil filter, and then you get some 15W40 diesel engine oil, and you do your service there. You can do it by yourself. Don't spend a whole lot of money doing that, guys. Don't pay nobody to do it, unless you're that, you know, like you're not confident that you don't want to touch it, right? So you can save a ton of money there. You can now tell that our blower fan has stopped blowing again because the compressor is now not running again. All right. So, but I'll be honest with you guys, I thought it was broke. The way it shut down and it stuttered and like hiccup, like misfired almost. And then it shut off and it was doing what it was supposed to do, guys. Okay, one little quick deal I forgot to mention is I have the Thermo King Tri-Pack Evolution. And if you have one, I could save you a little bit of trouble right here. That's your oil filter number right there. That is Thermo King 11-6182. That's for your oil filter. And this is your fuel filter. It is Thermo King 11-9342. Your boy Stevie Linguini about to show you something real quick. I'm going to show you how to plug your computer, your laptop, into your APU system in your unit and try to pull codes out of it. Okay, so on the let's see, I don't know if you can see in here. Let's see if we get the flash turned on. No, that didn't work. I got something for you though. I got something for you. That box back there, not this one, but the one back there, that's your fuse panel slash your, you know, your brain, your computer deal. There's a cable, a wire coming out from there, goes up here. I brought it out here. It is a USB cable, okay? Now just watch. We're gonna plug it in. And as you see right there, Tri-Pack Evolution is what we have for APU, and it is installed. It's already here on the computer for some reason. Oh, look at that. That's when your boy was at TMC. 10689, baby. Yeah, that was in Louisiana. That was in Louisiana. All right, back to the video. So we double click here, let it open up.
click on start. Microsoft Edge, allow access. Give it time to open up. Whoopsie. Come on. All right. When you get this screen pulled up here, which again, you don't have to download any software to your computer, guys, okay? You don't have to download any software. Factory is installed already on the computer for some reason. I'm gonna come down here to alarms. Click it, double click it. We're gonna see what codes we get. Loading alarms, okay? So it says something like the file or directory name this is corrupt and unreadable. Please run the check disk utility. All right, so get rid of that. Service test. We'll be back. I got my computer's out of date. I got it updated. Yo. So we're leaving Thermo King right now. We had to come in and get the evaporator blower assembly. I think the resistor failed in that, and I tried looking for just a replacement resistor. And I really didn't see any resistors by themselves. I'm sure you could get something like that from China somewhere, but at the same time, I believe in factory parts for most things. You spend a little bit more right now, and it's gonna pay off, guys. So we just left Thermo King, and it was $287 plus tax for the complete blower motor assembly with the resistor, all one unit, and it came out to about $315. So, you know what? We're just gonna go past right here. We're not gonna try to stop. But anyway, so that's what it is for the evaporator blower assembly with resistor, $315. And we should have cold air. We should be able to stop idling my truck, start saving on fuel and on, you know, general cost, general maintenance, engine, less idle hours and all that good stuff, guys. Anyway, I'll get back to you. get it in here. We have a problem. The fridge is oversized, right? So it stops the bunk from coming up. So I have to figure out how I'm gonna get past that and then prop this bunk up so I can access it. We are at, we're at a receiver right now on our drop number one. And so yeah, you know what it is. Let's get into it. Oh, what are you doing here? Pry bar from back in the day. It has been gorilla glued back into the handle. It's been a long time since I've been a mechanic. Let's just say that. All right. Let's see. And for that, I use my chirp wheel. It comes in handy for more than just spinal adjustments. Get yours today. That was a joke. I'm not getting no money from chirp wheel.
Here comes the really icky part.
See if we can do something better for you guys. Man, if I mess up my phone here for you guys, I better get some likes or something around here. See if that works. Wanted to go. Let's try something else. All right, we got our headlight mounted up here. We mounted our headlight right there. It's a headlamp. It goes on around your head. All right, it looks like this assembly is held in by, it looks like it's held in by two nuts. Maybe more, maybe not. Maybe it slides right down, guys, and it's held in by those two nuts right there. And this is how your resistor goes in. So we know when we put it in, we have the red jumper cable power, looks like, and it goes from this terminal to this one right here. Okay. In fact, okay, yeah. It's already like that on the new one. So we're good there. We're good there. Okay. Set that aside. So what's going to happen is these three wires here pretty much tell a story. They're going to kind of have memory as to what position they took. After you pull them off, they've been here so long like this, they'll probably just flop over in the right position like they're supposed to be. Okay? So we'll go ahead right now and pull them out. And if that, and just in case, you can always kind of makeshift a position. This one's the far right. Right? This one's going to be the middle. Far right, middle. This one's going to be the furthest on the left. There's that. Okay? Now you know exactly where they go. I got to figure out though. All right, then you've got one that goes on the very bottom down there, the white one, right here. You will take that off and put it on when you get this out. It's an easier to reach it that way. All right, let me figure this out real quick. I'll be back. And if you guys can see how I got this prop, as long as I don't knock it over or hit it or anything, we'll be good. It looks like I'm looking at a 8 or a 10 millimeter, something like that. This looks like a track, it just slides down in. This looks like it's just zip. It's just, it has, what do you call those? Zip ties holding that on. See if we can do something here. Pop that off like that, leave it there. Pop that off right there. These guys are gonna get unbolted and slide outward. They're gonna come this way toward me and up after I take these two bolts out, nuts out, it looks. Let's go get our tool. Looks like we have something on the backside that is stopping us. Man, go ahead. If you're here watching, man, please go ahead and smash like and subscribe. Hit the thumbs up, subscribe, tick the bell, man. I'm gonna do what I can to help you save money and to help you get where you're going. If there's something I know, I'm gonna help. Yeah, this thing is rusted all the way through, guys. After looking at this, I'm confident that this part has failed. Anyway, put our cap back on that I took off because that belongs there. That's in place. Okay. That white wire from bottom goes right there on that prong, that contact right there. All right. Successfully turn this on. And it'd be blowing cold air while we finish putting the bolts back in. That. Alright. You know what? I'm just gonna go for it real quick. see what happens. If we get cold air, then I can put it back the rest of the weight nice and cool. Let's go, baby. Let's go. Oh my God. Oh. Woo-hoo. Yes, sir. If you take this into Thermo King, you know what time it is. Mess with your boy Linguini, and I'm gonna put you on. You got me? One more time, guys. Hit the like, subscribe, tick the notifications, man. Throw me out to the algorithm. Help me help you, all right? Help me help a lot of people. I'm gonna do what I can, like I said, guys. Anyway, try to get this light switched up. That's better. Anyway, boy, oh boy, it's cooling me down. And you know what? It could have been a gamble to do that, but it really wasn't. I went I troubleshot it during the weekend. Everything else was fine, normal operation. These fans, I felt that you gotta pay attention as you're operating your equipment. How it happens can be everything. If she was strong for 4 months while I've had this truck, she was strong, guys. If she was strong for 4 months, and then you feel it get weaker, and it's starting to, you know, on a hot day, you start wondering, man, I feel really hot. You know, what's wrong with my APU? That'll tell you a lot right there. She was strong all the way up until then. When I lifted this bump the first time, I'm getting a little bit dry in my throat, guys. Been driving all day. When I lifted up this bunk the first time and smacked on them motors, they started going again. That's another thing you can pay attention to. Don't go pay the Thermo King, man, when you can lift up the bunk, smack on the motors first, and if they kick in, 95% the armatures are bad inside of the motors. They got rusted up, they wore out, and they're no longer gonna make good contact. And when you smack it, it does something that jolts it just enough to make a contact to get started. When it heats back up, it fails again. There is you another gem. All right, guys? Man, I'm done.